Welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to be taking a look at the five-piece Pure Ice Halloween collection. We haven't ever looked at a Halloween collection from Pure Ice before. In fact, we've only ever really looked at one collection in entirety before from Pure Ice. Usually you just see them in Swatch Fest, and that's because they don't generally put out like full collections in display that you can easily see. But as I was walking down through Walmart the other day picking up some Halloween, you know, decorative items, I saw this big rectangle display out in the middle of the walkway. Basically, it wasn't in the cosmetics section, and there are five new polishes that they show which polishes are new right on one of the sides, and so it was really easy to pick out which ones were new. They also had a bunch of other polishes in there that were new. They have the new sticker on them. They were new to me. Whether or not they're new to you, that just depends on how many Pure Ice polishes you've bought recently. But we're gonna go ahead and look at all five of these polishes. You guys know I really love Pure Ice. I think they do a great job for the price point. So we've got some toppers here, we've got purple orange things, so we're gonna go ahead and get right into this. I don't know if these polishes are available online, but I will put in the description bar if I see a place that you can easily get them online. Otherwise you might have to try to spot them in stores. So we're gonna quickly get into swatching all five. Before we do, I want to tell you what's on my lips today. This is a Zoya Lippy, and it is so comfortable, so creamy, and I think I've found my new favorite, like, slightly pinky nude. It's really, really nice and so easy to wear. This is Zoya Addy, and this is one of their new shades for fall 2017, fall winter, and that's what it looks like there on my hand. I mean, you can see it on my face. And I just like to tell you guys what's on my lips just because I get the question a lot, so I try to remember to tell you guys right up front. So let's get into swatching. I'm gonna start with what I have on my nails. This is one of my favorites in the collection. This is the beautifully bright orange, and it has gold shimmer. It's like a gold to green almost shimmer. It's really gorgeous. This is called Gorgeous. But the first part of the word is gourd, like the vegetable, a gourd, and then a hyphen, just. And this is one of my favorites because the formula is just really, really good. It's a really nice, like, juicy, almost sour orange. It's so gorgeous how it swatches so just easily, kind of buttery. I really, really like it. And then that shimmer is really strong and beautiful as well. So a great go-to Halloween orange if you don't already have one set for you for this fall, but also, you know, it's only $2, so you're not really making much of a commitment there if you go to purchase this polish, and so I definitely recommend it. Two coats, and my photo is two coats of top coat. This next photo is a topper, and it's a really beautiful kind of cherry red shade with flakies in there. We've got glitters, it looks like, and flakies, and they're just iridescent, so they're kind of shifty-shifty, but not incredibly so. It's just a little bit. So anyway, this one's called It's Alive! Exclamation point. And I tried to build this up on its own. I suppose you could wear it that way, especially if you don't have stained nails like me. My nails are really stained right now. I've just been really lazy about wearing base coat, to be honest with you, and that's why it's happening. Always wear base coat if you're wearing pigmented polishes. But anyway, you can usually cover your stained nails up with something, but in the case of something like this, it's a little bit sheer, and so I actually liked this best as a topper. It's also a little bit thick, and so when you go to add three coats, it's just kind of a lot on your nails. So I like this best as a topper. It just gives a nice cherry jelly squishy glow to whatever you're wearing underneath it. Now, of course, I didn't try this under like a green or anything. I would definitely recommend this over like a red or an orange. I actually did try this over a white, and I really didn't like the look. I don't like white base coats. I feel like it just doesn't lend to a very natural look for that polish. I feel like it just changes it too much, whatever you're putting over it. So anyway, I did like this. It wasn't my favorite out of the collection, I do have to admit, but it is fun. So this is It's Alive. The next polish in the collection is this beautiful blue with strong greeny gold shimmer, and this is really nice and deep and gorgeous in two coats. So this polish is called Dark Arts, and I feel like we've seen a lot of things like this lately. I'm pretty sure Simple Colors has one like this, and I think this is almost exactly the same as the one that KL Polish came out with lately. Basically, it's just a really deep saturated blue with a ton of this turquoise to green shifty shimmer, and it's really, really gorgeous. This one's only $2 though, and it's in Walmart, and it's really pretty. As you can see, I'm giving you two coats in my live application, and my photo will be two coats with top coat. So this is a pretty one. I would give this top marks, but I already have a few things like this. So anyway, this one's called Dark Arts. Next up, we're gonna look at the purple, and this is like a really deep royal purple, almost going towards a blue. It is stunning. It's called I Want You to Haunt Me. This is one of my favorites in this collection, and basically it's got like tonally similar to the base glitters in there, and it's just very sparkly and beautiful, and I'm showing this to you at two coats. You could maybe go for a third if you're having a little bit of patchiness, but yeah, I went two coats with top coat on the photo as well. So this is another one of my favorites. I Want You to Haunt Me. Okay, and the last polish out of the collection is another topper. And this polish, first of all, the name of it is Smoldering Cauldron. And this polish, I was only okay with it. Let me tell you why. The base of it, it would be better if the base were clear, but instead, in my opinion, but instead the base is kind of this cloudy gray shade. I don't know if it's because of some of the glitters were like bleeding or that's just how they wanted it to be, but it makes it so you can't really wear it over anything and have it just liven up whatever you're wearing, because it's gonna slightly tint whatever color it is to like that gray shade, which maybe is something that you want to, you know, maybe you want to be going for that for Halloween. That might work out okay. And then inside of here we have these beautiful purple hex glitters, and then it also has flakies in there that are kind of going orange to green, and they're kind of big, and they're more like shreds rather than flakies is how I see them. This topper was only okay for me. It wasn't as exciting. I think I liked the one in the Simple Colors Halloween collection, which you will be seeing from me later on. I think I liked that one a little bit better. This one just wasn't as versatile for me. Like, I don't feel like I can wear this as easily over whatever it is I want to. But it is a fun look still, and you know, like I said, it's only $2. So anyway, this one's called Smoldering Cauldron, and I think I just did one coat as a topper. I actually didn't even try to build this up at all, so I don't know, you know, if that might be a way you want to go as well. My instinct is that it's going to be too thick for that and not really give you enough coverage. So anyway, those were all five polishes in the collection. I hope you found this helpful. If you've been walking around your Walmart and seeing this big display and wondering what these polishes were all about, well, hopefully this answers your questions. So let me know in the comments down below what your favorite polish out of this collection is, and if you're going to be picking any of these up. I hope you're having a good one. Thanks for spending some of it with me, you guys. I love you, and I will see you back for the next video. Take care. Bye.